Did you know that Jupyter Notebooks can be automated? Join this session to see an example of how you can use Azure Data Studio and other tools like Azure Logic apps to automate your workflows. This week on Data Exposed. Hi, I'm Anna Hoffman, and welcome to this episode of Data Exposed. Today, I'm joined by Julie from the Azure Data team at Microsoft. Hi, Julie. Thanks for joining us today.
Hi, Anna. Nice to be here again today.
We're happy to have you here again on the show. Always a pleasure to have you on to talk about notebooks and Azure Data Studio and lots of exciting stuff that you and the team are working on. So today, we're going to be talking about automating some diagnostic notebooks. Can you just tell us a little bit more about why that's important or what you want to show us today?
Sure, of course. So in the past, probably a few presentations when I come on Data Exposed or other user groups or presentations, I've been talking about using notebooks specifically for diagnosis or for troubleshooting. So today I'm going to show you how to string it all together so that you can automate these diagnostic notebooks or troubleshooting guides notebooks. Maybe it's for routine or regular basis, or maybe it's for perhaps on-call scenario.
Cool. That sounds exciting. I love automating because it makes my life easier.
Sure, of course. All right, so let's get started with this one here. So this is a typical diagnostic notebook that someone has created. This particular one is actually from Glenberry. So imagine you have queries like this or notebooks with queries like this that you can execute on a regular basis. Perhaps it's for baselining, etc. But you could use these for kind of on-call scenario. So now let's take a look this demo here. Let me just share my screen. All right, so imagine you're an on-call DBA and you get tasks or issues or tickets like this way. It says slow query and then it's against this database. And imagine if it, when it's assigned to you, it will automatically pre-execute the diagnosis notebook. And then so that when you say, for example, look at the ticket next, you only need to open up the notebook itself, the pre-executed notebook, and review the outcome instead of having you manually do the execution. So wouldn't that be nice?
Yeah, that sounds really nice.
Yeah, and on top of that, you'll get an email. Maybe you don't pay attention to the, you know, ticketing system perhaps, but you get an email, and then simply you click on the, click to view this in Azure Data Studio, and then you'll get to see or review the pre-executed notebooks.
Wow, that seems pretty cool, Julie. My only question is is this kind of hard to set up, or was it easy, and how did you do it?
It's actually pretty easy to set up. We're actually using this sort of system in-house as well within our team. So I'm going to show you a brief demo of how you can do this on your own sort of environment. So let's check this out. All right. So here's an example of a ticketing system. So imagine there is a task that someone has created, and maybe you are the person who's triaging. So imagine it gets assigned to someone. Say for now, let's just say it's assigned to me. And then when it gets assigned to me, it's going to kick off a certain job, actually. And then it will do all the things that I mentioned earlier, including the emailing and updating the notebook. So this is going to take a couple of minutes. While we do that, let's take a look at how it works under the hood. Okay, here what we have is Azure Logic Apps. And this is where the brain or the orchestration happens. When I click on the edit button, you'll be able to see something like this where it shows you the workflow. So when a task is assigned to me, in this case, my demo ticketing system is actually using Planner, it will actually create a job that is based on Azure Automation job, and it will run a runbook called Infolk SQL Notebook. And this runbook is actually pretty straightforward. It's just a PowerShell script. So if you're familiar with PowerShell, you will love using this. And we will pass the parameter, which is the title of the issue, so that we can get the server name, the database name. And then after that, the rest of the workflow is just simply updating back to the planner task so that it has all the details to the, you know, the link to the pre-executed notebook or the output notebook. And then after that, the next step is just simply emailing you the details, like the one that I, you know, showed you a little bit earlier. Okay, so cool. It's actually pretty nice, isn't it? Very intuitive.
I like that you didn't have to write a bunch of code. Like, that's the best part of logic apps for me.
Yeah. So here's the InfoSQL notebook runbook that I mentioned earlier. And if I click on edit here, you'll see a bit of PowerShell. It's pretty straightforward, actually. Simply, it takes the title, it will do some regex thing, and it will just parse in the, say, for example, the Contoso database name and server name. And then next, I'm actually using manage identity here to give access to my database for this app to execute in my database. But before that, I need to download the notebook first, so which is on GitHub. So the next step here is essentially to call the notebook that I've just downloaded and run it against the server name database name that I got from the title earlier. And then simply just save it in an output, and the output is going to be stored in blob storage. And most of this part here that makes it sound long or looks long is actually to do with security. And it's very important to take care of security, right? So the overflow today that I've shown you is just simply using logic apps and then the Azure Automation account where it hosts all the runbooks. And the runbook is actually written in PowerShell. And then store the output notebook in a container. So that's essentially the workflow.
Awesome, cool. I mean, it seems like you really mastered this. Hopefully we can share some of your work later at the end.
yeah, of course. So let me just take a look here and see whether the execution has been completed. It looks like it has. So let me just bring it up. So it's actually been emailed to me, so as you can see. And then if I go back to this and refresh it, it looks like it also has been completed. See how I have a link to the notebook, the output notebook. And then if I click on this here, it will open Azure Data Studio.
Wow, so this is just going to make it a lot easier in this scenario for a DBA to go and troubleshoot, or, you know, in this case, I think we were analyzing a slow query, so we can go through and have this pre-run so we can just get to work without having to do all the admin related tasks.
Yeah, indeed. So let me just scroll down a little bit just to show you here where the query get executed inside the notebook. And then in the next cell here, I purposely don't give enough access for that app to run against my database. That's why it's giving me the few server state permission. That's just to show you a quick test that you can manage the security in this way, so that you don't give all admin access. You can say that I only want to give certain access. So that's pretty cool, right?
Yeah, very cool. You know, Julie, a lot of people when they're like maybe doing similar tasks or like something gets assigned to them, everyone has like their toolbox of scripts and they're going to go to those scripts and kind of copy and paste the scripts that they need depending on the problem that comes up. Like, how would you compare what you showed us today to kind of the control C, control V method?
Yeah, a very good question. So in the SRE world, which is site reliability engineering, we consider control C and control V as toil. So it's like manual execution. So instead of spending time on manual execution, what if you can automate a lot of things so that your time is better spent on solving better, bigger problems? So if I were to paint the whole picture of what you could do in your environment, it would look like something like this, where perhaps you have a data engineer or DBA that creates troubleshooting guides notebooks, and then you have them checked in the troubleshooting guides notebooks in GitHub or Azure DevOps. Then you have someone like a support who might triage the issues, and then you have someone like Gloria or DBA, so in this case, in this early demo, that's me, who actually just simply enjoy all this automation output and, you know, get back to work in terms of, you know, just reviewing what's going on, what's wrong, and then mitigate it. So it's pretty nifty.
Awesome. Cool. That's really cool. I love the story, and I like that you played Gloria.
Yeah. just to kind of tidy all up about all the concepts that we've probably been talking about at Data Exposed and various sort of Azure Data Studio presentations, when we talk about notebooks, we talk about manual execution through Azure Data Studio, which is kind of nice when you develop. But remember that if as much as possible, if you can reuse the troubleshooting guides or those notebooks that you run routinely on manual mode, if you can automate them as well, that means you don't have to write a lot of things. So hopefully your notebooks are reusable. And then last stage is automation or automatable. So earlier I actually showed you how to use Azure Logic Apps, but underneath it's actually essentially just really calling in folks SQL notebook. And that is used for invoking SQL notebooks through CLI, or in this case, through Azure Automation. You can also do it through Azure Function as well if you'd like. And if you have PowerShell notebooks, you could also invoke execute notebook. And if you're using Python notebook, then simply use papermill. So that's it. That's it from me today.
Awesome. Well, Julie, this has been so interesting. And I see you have a bunch of resources. So we'll be sure to put those in the description so folks can go learn more and check out these samples and start automating their workflows. I just want to thank you so much for coming on the show. And to our viewers, if you like this episode, go ahead and give it a like. Check out Azure Data Studio. Check out the automation capabilities. And we hope to see you next time on Data Exposed.